I'm now going to present our first speaker, who has been doing a lot of enabling and facilitating, Barbara Unmüßig, if you maybe can come up. Applause for Barbara Unmüßig. She's the president. She is the president of Heinrich Böll Foundation. She has studied political science at Freie Universität Berlin and has been active in North-South political issues as a researcher and publisher since the 1980s. She has done so many things. But one thing in particular, she has been already coordinating German NGOs at the famous Rio Conference in 92. And she has been involved for a long time in building up the Heinrich Böll Stiftung, first as a chairman of the supervisory board.
Chairwoman, please.
And now as one of its two presidents. Now, if I may ask you an initial question, how does it feel for you to have this conference here today?
Yeah, of course, great. I'm very proud having you here again. I think it's, I will refer to that, it's a common effort. But you can imagine, for me, it's really wonderful to meet people again and to, yeah, just to be host of such a big event for the upcoming 2.5 days.
Thanks very much. Barbara will speak about building bridges and about not allowing the commons to be fragmented. And please, here you go.
Thank you so much and good afternoon. And ladies and gentlemen, dear friends, and of course, welcome for you, the commoners. I would like to welcome you on behalf of the Common Strategies Group, the Charles Leopold Mayer Foundation, and Remix the Commons. Welcome, and I would like to open this conference on behalf of the four organizations who made this going to happen. Thank you at the beginning for the four organizations. For me, I think it's a great, great pleasure to be host and co-organizer for this second international conference on the commons. Many of you may have participated in the first one in this very same spot in November 2010. I think a lot of documentation is around about the November meeting, and many people will recall this event almost 3 years ago. It makes us confident to bring together some of the most active, thoughtful commoners from around the world. I'm very much looking forward for 2.5 days of debates and real mutual exchange. There are great expectations for the learning that will take place and new friends and colleagues that each of us will get to know. Once again, this conference, like the last one in November 2010, is an experiment. We at the Heinrich Böll Foundation see ourselves as providing an important space for networking, learning, and the incubation of new ideas and projects. And I think such an institution like Heinrich Böll Foundation has really to spend, I even would say, money and time for creating those spaces, because we need spaces to think and to rethink more than ever in decades where we are suffering from a lot of crisis. Once again, let me explain how we have designed this conference, and I also would like to explain what this conference is not designed for. First, as you easily can see, this is above all an international conference. We have more than 200 participants from more than 30 different countries of the world. Argentina, Bolivia, Brazil, Canada, Costa Rica, Croatia, France, India, Indonesia, Italy, even Mali, welcome, Mexico, the Philippines, Poland, Senegal, Spain, Tunisia, the United Kingdom, and the United States, to name just a few. We have commoners who deal with forests and fisheries and with water and farmlands. We have commoners who deal with software and the internet and with social media and open source hardware design. We have commoners who are trying to reclaim urban life and spaces, and commoners who are trying to preserve and extend scientific knowledge and creative works. We have commoners who are defending subsistence commons and commons maintained by indigenous peoples. What a richness, I would say. Whatever the commons, we want to organize them in ways that take gender perspectives into account and overcome structural injustices that still disadvantage mainly women. I think this diversity is our strength here, not only in the room, but everywhere where you are working for creating and maintain the commons. Our overriding goal is to explore the commons as a shared paradigm that embraces all of these commons. As I and we understand it, the distinction between natural commons and knowledge commons is, I would like to say, somewhat artificial. Because, and this is, we really want to bring forward, all commons are based on knowledge in one way or another. Whether it's free software or open access publishing or forest or shared farmland, a community's collective knowledge is an indispensable part of commoning. In short, all commons are knowledge commons and all commons are social commons. A great deal of the conference will be devoted to exploring how to bridge the lines that appear to separate us, the divisions between the so-called natural resources and the digital commons, and the divisions between those of the northern and the northern industrialist countries and those of the global south, and the divisions between commoners who use a scientific or academic discourse and those who are more political and activist oriented. The way to overcome these divisions is to recognize that the commons movement is about much more than any particular resource, location, or historical experience, important as they are. This is why we want to take special care to avoid sectoralization of the commons and the further fragmentation of the commons discussions and the fragmentations of activists. I think we all know if we are joined, we are stronger. Over the last few years, it has become clear that there is truly a great convergence among commoners, but it's not an easy, automatic, or uniform process. This is why a key intention of this conference is to further clarify our understanding of the commons and to make concrete plans for moving forward, both theoretically and practically. Inevitably, our visions and plans will reflect a great diversity of ideas and approaches, but unified by certain fundamental principles and shared commitments. Let me even add, let's not be afraid of utopia. Only if we imagine the world of tomorrow, we can start building it in the world today. We see this conference definitely as an open space that will allow us to explore the commons freely and honestly, with critical intelligence, but also with tolerance and respect for our differences. Perhaps the most important technique of commoning is the capacity to listen, really listen to each other, even if we do not agree. I see this as the only way that we can come together to forge a shared political vision and to coordinate plans for moving forward in the future. But even as we try to forge a sense of common purpose amidst difference, we want our conversations here to have some focus and some structure. This is why we devised 5 different streams with their own coordinators, themes, and breakout sessions. These streams deal with the commons as they deal with land and water, working and caring, knowledge and culture, infrastructure, and money and value. We will also have a concluding keynote on a topic that cuts across all these streams: life, spirituality, and the search for meaning. We are very, very grateful to the stream coordinators for their handwork in pulling together their respective stream. I really would like to thank Saki Bailey, Mike Linkswayer, Miguel Vieira, Stephen Meritz, Ludwig Schuster and Heike Löschmann, as well as Andreas Weber. Thank you so much for all the work you did for getting these streams together. I think a clap. The Common Strategies Group, the Heinrich Böll Foundation, the Charles Leopold Mayer Foundation, and Remix the Commons, the 4 organizers of this conference, see these streams as critical for the future of the commons. We need to clarify the challenges that we face in each of these areas. We very much hope that the conference will provide some space for helping us identify the key political challenges that need to be addressed, to catalyze imagination and formulate the most strategic and effective ways to advance the commons paradigm in your country and around the globe. All ideas are most welcome, well beyond these 2.5 days. We want to continue to make fruitful exercises here to bring it home to your local or country-based activities. While the Heinrich Böll Foundation is thrilled to be hosting this Economics and Commons Conference, please know it's your conference. Let us make best use out of it. Let me end with a big, big thank to all of those who helped us to make this happen, who worked very hard for many months ahead for this opening, to conceptualize, to set the stage, to get you here, and to provide you with food and shelter. Thank you for our, thank you and our cooperation partners for this such big effort. But allow me to single out just a few individuals. First, the members of our strategic partner, the Commons Strategies Group. My personal thank you goes once again to Silke Helfrich, David Bollier, and Michael Bowens. Thank you so much. And definitely, I would like to extend my very cordial thank to Heike Löschmann. She is the heart and the key person here in the Heinrich Böll Foundation. She is the bridge builder of those what is happening around the commons worldwide to us in the Heinrich Böll Foundation and, of course, as well to me personally. Thank you, Heike, and your team to bring us here. My thank you goes also to Frederick and Nicolas and your teams in Paris and Lausanne. And I think it's worthwhile to mention that the cooperation, the partners who are co-organizing this conference are coming from France and Switzerland, and I think that's good news as well. Just my last word. Once again, it's your conference. Make best use out of it. And I herewith declare this conference open now. Thank you very much for your attention and welcome once again.